Xarelto continues to kill patients, while the FDA continues to ignore it. See the story at drugsafetynews.com.
You know, it's amazing to me that the kind of the economists that the establishment Democrats have in their pocket, that they can pull out, like, kind of like the gimps on Pulp Fiction, you know, where they pull that gimp out of the box and it's time for him to perform whatever weird thing that he does. That's just kind of the same thing with Democrats and Republicans, both sides of it. Right now, we're seeing the Democrats go to their go-to people like Paul Krugman, people like that, to say that Bernie Sanders' plans don't work. You know, four economists on one side say they do work. Krugman and some other folks say they won't work. Well, look where the Krugman ties go. They go directly to the Democratic establishment. What is your take on this this healthcare story that Sanders has introduced into the public narratives?
Well, I think it's interesting. You know, Bernie Sanders has dozens of economists that have signed letters of support saying that his proposals, everything from healthcare to taxing Wall Street, are the only route to basically save the country. But it's really been, you know, Hillary's surrogates, you know, the little puppets like Claire McCaskill going out there in the media and telling us that it's impossible for President Sanders to institute health care for all. We simply can't afford it, so don't vote for him. Vote for Hillary because she's more realistic than Bernie Sanders. And so a lot of the talk has gone to the economics of health care or any of his other proposals, and they say the numbers don't add up. But the numbers that they're using, you know, unfortunately, to quote George W. Bush, it's fuzzy math. They're basing it on existing revenues and existing expenditures. If we were to take a small portion of the budget that the Pentagon gets every single year, we could very easily and very effectively institute a healthcare for all here in the United States and finally catch up with the rest of the world that's been doing it for decades.
Well, isn't part of the story here the resistance of the Clinton camp? Doesn't that tell us something? Okay, first of all, we went through all this with Obama. Obama was running for president. You know what? When I win for president, we're going to do something about Wall Street. We're going to throw some people in jail. We're going to do something about climate. We're going to do all of these, this list that he gave us. You remember that?
Yeah.
I'm going to investigate here. I'm going to stop this problem here. I'm going to stop offshore taxes. I'm going to do all of these things. And we go, wow, that's great. But here with Hillary, of course, he never did it, but that's another story. But the point being, with Hillary, we have this, we're already hearing, I can't, I can't, I can't. Not, I can, and change is possible. What's your take on this new, I can't message that we keep hearing from Hillary?
Well, if Obama's campaign slogan was, yes, we can, Hillary's is obviously, no, we can't. And it is very weird to hear a presidential candidate, somebody out there trying to convince the public that they're the best choice, saying, well, we can't do this. We can't do that. We shouldn't do this. Just don't look at my campaign financing to find out why I'm saying these things aren't possible,
yeah.
Which is something that the Hillary supporters, unfortunately, are not doing. You know, why does Hillary not want to take on Wall Street? Well, because they've made her a multimillionaire. Why are we not getting health care for all? Well, because the insurance industry and the big pharma lobbyists are paying Hillary Clinton's campaign
funds. How about this question? Why is it that Hillary wouldn't be willing to cut the defense budget just a little bit to pay for health care? What's the rest of that sentence?
Well, the defense industry, not only are they giving to her campaign, but they've been huge funders of the Clinton Foundation. And that story is something you and I talked about 8 months ago, drove Hillary supporters absolutely crazy because they don't want to accept the truth. And these are just facts.
Yeah.
You know, the
God
defense
knows.
Industry
let's
funded
not,
the
let's,
Clinton
let's
Foundation.
Let's not talk about facts. Poor H. Goodman. I mean, you know, every time he talks about Hillary, you think they want to blast him to the moon.